Hi guys, I'm Zhuwa. Thank you for watching this video. Food, or cans as my guildmates like to call them, is the most important resource in the game. Without food, you can't play single player to get more food, and you can't participate in raids to get better units and get supplies or coins. And you also can't research without food. In fact, it costs a crazy amount of food to research, tens of thousands of cans of food. For example, the second best tier of the upgrading the detergent is 250,000 cans of food. Insane! Food is important. Or it's called Steam C, I guess, not detergent. But I call it detergent. I think all players eventually come to the conclusion that there is a necessity to grind for food. But there's one trick or one technique you can use to grind for food, for not just food, but more coins as well. How does it work? Well, consider two things. According to the data of food returns from single player stages I have accumulated or dropped down, I mean how much food the game rewards you when you successfully finish a single player stage. In general, stages that use the same minimum team power give you the same amount of food. Now look here, for example, Bangkok. Sawadika. So, normal Bangkok costs 1,400 minimum team power. So, I'll just show you here what I mean. So, it's easy. So, 1,400, quick fight. I'm sorry. Why? Stop watching funny videos when I'm recording my game. What's your problem? You're like giggling next to me. I'm trying to sound professional here. I'm reading from a script. Okay, Bangkok. Quick fight. 850 cost, and then you will get... And then you will get... there you go. 1,762 food. I know because I'm a psychic like Patrick Jane, or I actually copied down the results. So, that was normal Bangkok. Now let's go to New Orleans. Which should be quite cool because I saw this movie with Will Smith in it called Focus. Really good movie. Go check it out. I saw it with my wife. Do you like Focus? The movie with Will Smith in it?
Focus, yeah. Like it.
Good. Very See? Cool. She likes it too. Okay, back to the game. Sorry. It's weekend. Bear with me. So, same cost, Andrew and Freddy, and you will get the exact same amount of food. 1,762. Now let's wait for it to load. Ta-da! See? So, okay, back to my script. So as you can see, I mean, at first thought, it just means that they're equivalent. I should be indifferent to which stage I play. However, also consider this piece of information. Sometimes when you play stages, the stage gives you coins at the end. For normal stages, it's 10 coins. I'm sure everybody has seen it. However, for hard stages, it actually gives you 15 coins. As you can see in this screenshot. Yes. See? I actually played another stage. I forgot what. Doesn't matter. The main point... sorry. Yeah, this is Expert. Right, Rio de Janeiro. You can see it gives you 25 coins. But if you... Yes. So, if you play a hard stage, for example, this is Hard Vancouver, and you're lucky enough, you get 15 coins. Okay, so I think that's all I wanted to show you. Go back to the game. So, as you can see, even though the amount of the team power required is the same, and the amount of food required is the same, playing a harder difficulty actually gives you more coins. One caveat is that I'm assuming the coin drop rate is the same across difficulties. So far it doesn't feel different. Definitely normal stages do not give you, for example, 50% more coins than hard stages do. That's for sure. So, according to this, when you grind for food, if your team power meets the minimum team power of a higher difficulty stage, you should definitely go for the higher difficulty stage to get more coins while you grind for food. So that's it from me, and thank you for watching this video. How do you grind for food? Leave a comment in the comment section below. If you like my videos, help me out by leaving a like. I'm Zhuwa, and have a good day.